I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on.
Marcia Holton, guest vocalist at this year's Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. birthday observance. Hello and welcome to Meade Week. I'm Brian Spann. More from the celebration in a moment. Also this week, the Tax Assistance Center is set to open. A Fort Meade community member celebrates 105 years, and the 2020 installation guides and calendars are in. These stories and more, but first, Major General Omar Jones, Commanding General of the Military District of Washington, hosted the latest quarterly town hall focused on post-housing this week at the theater. The General was joined by Garrison leadership, including Garrison Commander Colonel Eric Sprague. The panel also included representatives from the Housing Office and privatized housing contractor Corvius Military Living.
I will tell you, big picture, I think we continue to make progress across the installation when it comes to housing in our barracks, but it's not where it needs to be, and we've got some work to do. And I think the team's gonna talk about that tonight. I think they've got some good presentations teed up, and very frankly, the part I'm most looking forward to is hearing from you all.
One of those presentations came from Corvius Operations Director J.C. Calder, who in his opening remarks detailed not just what Corvius is doing to address current issues, but he looked to the future as well.
We're getting ready to break ground on 115 new town homes in Meade Heights. Meade Heights is the area that's right outside the gate. The site work there will start in the second quarter of 2020. We have 150 new town homes that we're building in Muse Forest. The site work will start on that next month, so in February. So with those two combined, we'll break ground this year on 265 new homes.
After opening remarks, the panel addressed questions and concerns for just over an hour. You can watch the town hall in its entirety on Facebook. Just go to the events tab on the Fort Meade Facebook page, click on the town hall event, and the video is in the discussion thread. In other news from right here at Public Affairs, the 2020 installation guides, calendars, and maps have been delivered. They're available at multiple locations across the post, including the neighborhood housing centers. If you or your organization require a large number of guides, please contact Larry Whitley at Garrison Public Affairs. The phone number is 301-677-5602. Elsewhere, she was born on January 15, 1915 in West Virginia. She's been a member of the Fort Meade community for decades and continues to this day to be an active volunteer. On January 17th, the Post Garden Club surprised Marion Jordan with a 105th birthday celebration.
I'm really shocked today because they celebrated my 100th birthday, but I had no idea that they were going to do this today.
We asked Ms. Jordan what it feels like to be 105.
Really and truly, I don't feel that I'm 105, but I am, and that's just the number.
How old do you feel?
I feel like I'm about 60 or 70.
Oh, really?
Today I do.
You can learn more about Ms. Jordan in this week's edition of our award-winning newspaper, The Sound Off. Meanwhile, another reminder, the Joint Installation Tax Assistance Center is set to open on Monday, that's January 27th. It will remain open through April 15th for tax assistance and electronic filing. The center offers free tax return preparation services for active duty service members, retirees, dependents, and reservists on active duty orders. You can make an appointment by calling 301-677-9366. Finally this week, if you saw our last show, you know that we've started a podcast. Fort Meade Declassified allows us to go into what's going on at Fort Meade without time constraint. This week, we just want to let you know that Fort Meade Declassified is now available on iTunes. Just search for Fort Meade Declassified and it should come right up. You'll want to subscribe so you don't miss an episode. And that's Meade Week for this week. I'm Brian Spann. For everyone at Meade TV and the Fort Meade Public Affairs Office, have a great weekend and a great Meade Week.